Hello guys, this is Vinita and you're watching me on India.com and Bollywood Live. The man in my interview today is someone who remained an Ishikizada for a long time and then emerged as everyone's favorite gunda, only to be winning the hearts by becoming Pinky on screen recently. So let's welcome Arjun Kapoor in the house today. Welcome, Arjun.
No, you're most welcome. Thank you for such a lovely article. I'm sorry I couldn't do this interview earlier. I was caught up with some personal matters which needed a bit more addressing than me talking nicely about my own career right now. But I'm in a better place now to be able to have that chat.
So I hope everything is good, Arjun, there. And thank you for reading the article.
No, I really liked it. And the thing is, that's what actors work for at the end of the day, for somebody to recognize the nuances of your own personal life and career. So it's nice to know that people do pay attention. It's not always something that you living in your own bubble can realize, that people are noticing what you're doing at a macro level. So it's nice to know that happens.
So Arjun, you know your latest movie, Sandeep or Pinky Farrar, I think it's a different kind of film, which of course comes with the brand of your director, Dibakar Banerjee. But I don't know, it doesn't seem to me a film that would come from a brand of Arjun Kapoor, you know. So, and I heard you saying in one of your recent interviews that, you know, you listen to your heart while accepting this movie. So tell me this, is this the plan now, doing only those movies that your heart allows?
मुझे तो हर तरह की फिल्में करनी है यार. आई वॉन्ट टू डू ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ फिल्म्स. सो आई एम हैप्पी दिबाकर बैनर्जी, संदीप और पिंकी फरार कैन ओपन अप न्यू एवेन्यूज फॉर द ऑडियंस टू सी मी इन दैट लाइट एंड फॉर डायरेक्टर्स एंड फिल्म मेकर्स टू ऑफर मी फिल्म्स इन दैट लाइट. आई विल बी वेरी हैप्पी.
Yeah. So Arjun, you talked about perception. Has that perception ever bothered you? Like, did you ever feel like, you know, like you know, I have to just break this shackle around me, you know, like I have to now do this.
So I'm quite a patient person, Avinita. क्या ना, ये फिल्म दो साल पहले आने वाली थी. दो साल से लगी नहीं थी फिल्म because of COVID.
Yeah.
You get used to saying, okay, एक टाइम आएगा when things will change around, when this film will get its due. कभी ना कभी होगा. I never thought it'll be this big and this soon. I actually thought कि Dibakar Banerjee's film will be seen over the course of the next 3-5 years at a level and spoken about in small sections. I never thought about it directly ki yaar mujhe ye todna hai. It's always there in your head that yeah, if you get the right film you must. But I was very clear yaar, farar karne ke baad ye nahi ki main isse dar jaun, ye type of cinema se, you know, ki I want to do a gritty, realistic, new age mainstream stuff. I don't want to shy away from that. So that was always playing in my mind, and I don't think it was to break perception. It was more to remind people of the actor that I am. Because Ishakzade, I think I did a very good job. I am not Parma. I am not Ajay or Vishal from Aurangzeb, nor am I Bala from Gunde, nor am I like Krish from Two States. So there is a certain, if you see my first 4-5 films, it's not like I've played to my strengths. I've done all kinds of films. Yeah. And sometimes that gets forgotten in the course of you being overtly commercial and then films not working. जब मेनस्ट्रीम फिल्में नहीं चलती तो परफॉर्मेंसेस की तारीफ कम होती है. क्या होता है ना, पूरा ब्लेम आप पे आ जाता है. सो समवेयर पीपल फॉरगेट दैट एट द एंड ऑफ द डे यू आर अ गुड इनफ एक्टर टू कैरी योर रोल्स. फिल्म्स आर नॉट वर्किंग बट योर परफॉर्मेंसेस आर नॉट ऑल्सो बीइंग अप्रिशिएटेड टू दैट डिग्री बिकॉज द फिल्म्स आर नॉट वर्किंग. इट बिकम्स कोरिलेटेड रादर देन इट बीइंग लुक्ड एट इंडिपेंडेंटली. इन्होंने काम ठीक किया, वो फिल्म नहीं अच्छी. क्या होता है ना, ये हो जाता है, यू गेट क्लब टुगेदर विद द फिल्म वाज नॉट गुड एंड द एक्टर वाज वेरी बैड. बट दैट्स, आई नो फॉर अ फैक्ट आई एम नॉट अ बैड एक्टर. सो समटाइम्स इट्स जस्ट नाइस टू रिमाइंड पीपल दैट यू आर अ गुड एक्टर. संदीप और पिंकी डिड दैट, सो आई एम हैप्पी अबाउट इट. दैट्स इट. परसेप्शन ब्रेक करना वेक करने से ज्यादा था कि यार आई शुड जस्ट रिमाइंड पीपल मैं वही एक्टर हूँ जो आपको 9 साल पहले मिला था इशकजादे में.
Right, and that has happened.
Yeah.
Arjun, of course, from now here you're again going to this overtly, you know, commercial sort of mainstream cinema, you know, 8 minutes.
Mainstream, yeah.
Returns. Now, are there any apprehensions? Like, do you now think that you will be judged and maybe you'll be judged more because now you have done this and now you have this immensely commercial thing at your hand?
No, but I think it's important to test yourself all the time. So if we've been able to accomplish a tick mark with Sandeep or Pinky Farrar, I have confidence in Mohit Suri and his brand of cinema as a director. I mean, if there is a Dibakar Banerjee, there's also Mohit Suri's style of cinema filmmaking. He's a filmmaker who's far more experienced than even me. And we're doing a proper summer blockbuster tentpole kind of film, and there is a mainstream audience for that that enjoys it. That's for the theaters. So no, I'm not nervous about it. I think it's of course very difficult to balance both. So the test is ki kitna balance kis taraf jaate rahega. But wo, that is the excitement of being an actor where you listen. I'm so lucky. I get to do a villain and a Sandeep or Pinky Farrar. If you look at it.
Yeah.
So and that's the thing. And that at the end of the day, that is what is exciting. So I can't say I'm pressurized by it. I'm excited to see the results. I have full faith in Ek Villain. And there is John Abraham, Tara, Disha, Mohit Sudhi, Mohit Sudhi's music, the way he'll present us. So it's a very different, it's not a mainstream film that is brainless in that sense. You know, it's not just coming in to just be frivolous. There is a story, there are characters, there are twists, turns, there is a plot in there. So I'm quite excited about Villain being put in front of the audience.
Yeah. Okay, Arjun, I was reading your interviews and you know, you recently talked about health issues in one of your recent interviews. Would you mind elaborating on, you know, how you are dealing with these issues and what is your schedule like these days?
No. Yeah, wo baat hum karenge aaram se when I'm ready to speak about it. It's not, the thing is, you know, these are certain things that then get misused or misconstrued by the audience or by people who like to take advantage of it. These are not things that I'm averse to sharing, but I think at the right time when I'm ready to talk about it openly, it's better. And I
but
definitely
you are okay, right? Just, all is good.
Oh yeah. I'm fine. I'm fighting fit and I'm giving 200% of positive energy and I'm coping really well with my body, mind, everything. That all is going well. But there is a journey, you know, people go through highs and lows, even health-wise, mental, physical, in all aspects. So
yeah.
I think I'll be ready to speak about it more coherently rather than just do it in the middle of one interview, mention it one off. So when I'm ready to talk about it, I'll come out and properly speak about it so I can give respect to that phase of my life. Rather than just making it something that I'm using as an interview ka answer. But I'm good, trust me. If I wasn't, I wouldn't be sitting in front of you.
That's a relief, Arjun. Okay, so Arjun, about your roles, of course. Does growing in personal life help an actor to pick certain kind of mature roles in the career moving forward? Like, I just want to know, how does personal life affect a person's professional choices?
A lot, yeah, because jo main 26 saal ki umar mein tha, aaj main 36 ki umar mein nahi hu na. I was 26 when I chose to do an Aurangzeb or a Gunde, and today I'm going to turn 36 and my choices will be different because I've seen life differently.
Yeah.
I've been through more highs and lows. Although I was always quite mature, I have to say. But 10 years of living life automatically makes you a little more mature. But at the same time, I don't think that means you go towards darker or heavier material. It just means that you try and find things that excite you at a personal level far more than, so a 28-year-old, 29-year-old Arjun would get excited by your audience ko ye pasand hai, ye kar. A 37, 38-year-old Arjun hopefully will be more intimate and more personal about saying, yaar, this story appeals to me more. I, as an audience, feel I want to make this story.
Yeah.
And that divide is very slim, but it is very real.
Yeah.
So you have to, you put yourself in the forefront slightly more with your personal experience and your personal life. And experience is not only your personal life of your relationships, it's just the life that you lead. It's just ek thehrav aata hai. You just think a little more calmly. So I would say you start your career and films choose you, then you choose films, and then you find an in-between or some films choose you and you choose some films. So I think I'm at that phase where I'll hopefully be able to find that balance of some films finding me and me finding some films.
Yeah. Thanks, Arjun. Okay, Arjun, I have got some quick, like a collection of fans question and a rapid fire question.
Okay.
So I just mix them together.
Sure.
So let's begin now. So when are you and Ranveer Singh coming back together on screen?
I think we both would love to. We both are constantly in touch and we behave as silly as always. When in the next couple of years, you never know. Yeah, something good might come in. I think now is the time of awesomes. And Gunde was ahead of its times in terms of just two boys put together to make a nice mainstream commercial entertainer. So I think it's inevitable. Ranveer and me will be back together soon.
Right. Have you two been offered a film together, though, after Gunde?
After Gunde? No, not directly. I mean, we met at get-togethers and events where people have seen us and they've always spoken about our ARP. We want to make a film with two of y'all and stuff like that. And it's always, there's a lot of chatter around our pairing or our combination. But aisa nahi hai ki hame koi concrete film aayi hai saath.
Right. Okay. So will we see you rocking six-pack abs in Ek Villain 2?
Yes, of course.
And are you going bare-bodied? That is not my question. That is a question that one of your fans...
That when you see the film, you'll find.
Right. If you ever decide to work in a remake of one of your dad's films, which one would that be?
Let him decide that. But I think remakes ka time thoda sa bhi sensitive. Okay, it's better to focus on new authentic material. We have to respect that those films come with a certain fan following. So if he chooses it and he finds the right director and there's a genuine need for a remake, then I'll go with it. I personally don't like to touch the films that he's made there because they're unique in their own way.
Yeah. Okay. Would you mind collaborating with your real life partner on screen sometime?
Never say never in life. I haven't really dwelled on it. I don't think that's something that's crossed my mind also. But in life, like I said, never ever say never.
Right. Okay, Arjun. The meanest thing you have heard about yourself or read?
I try not to remember it because it's not important.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you so very much, Arjun. I wish you the best.
Thank you.
I wish you keep entertaining with such heartwarming roles and movies.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Arjun.
See you.
Thank you. Bye.